never could. Now we see everything that's going wrong with the world and those who lead it. We just feel like we don't have the means to rise above and beat it. We keep waiting,
waiting,
waiting on the world to change. We keep on waiting,
waiting,
waiting on the world to change. It's hard to beat the system when we're standing at a distance. So we keep waiting,
waiting,
waiting on the world to change. That's why we're waiting,
waiting,
waiting on the world to change. We keep on waiting,
waiting,
waiting on the world to change. It's not that we don't care, it's just that we know the fight ain't fair. We keep waiting,
waiting, waiting on the world to change.
Waiting on the world to change. Waiting on the world to change.
Good morning. I'm Lisa Tucker Gray, and we are Trinity Episcopal Church, a progressive, inclusive, creative community of faith whose building is located in downtown Toledo, Ohio, but whose membership and participation are now worldwide. Wherever you find yourself on your spiritual journey, know that you are welcome and wanted here. Some of you have downloaded the bulletin for today's service, and that will give you the words and the music that we will make together. You may also just open your heart and know that when we are invited to sing and pray and read together, we will provide words on the screen. So now open your heart and prepare to receive the love that God has for you today. Welcome home.
Love is found in water, wine, and wheat.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
May you find sanctuary among trees and stones, and feel earth preparing a place for you to sit and breathe and be. Let the long limbs of branches form a canopy above your head. Let the hills open up a place for you to soar. May the stones form an altar and see how the sun makes everything shimmer and glisten so that everything shines forth from within. Let the tender vine climbing the trunk show you what it is to reach to the sky. Let all the living creatures that gather, winged and four-footed ones, offer a new companionship. All around you, see yourself as part of this glorious cathedral. The lake and holy wells are the fonts of baptism. The river rushes carrying gifts down from the mountains. The oaks and sycamore create a sacred circle, the face of the Creator incarnate and imminent, illuminated with each gaze. Feel the veil between heaven and earth slip away until you know the sanctuary of soil and sunlight. Listen to the sky whisper her secrets on the wind, lifted by wings and song.
A reading from the book of Joshua. Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and summoned the elders, the heads, the judges, and the officers of Israel, and they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, long ago your ancestors, Terah and his sons Abraham and Nahor, lived beyond the Euphrates and served other gods. Then I took your father Abraham from beyond the river and led him through all the land of Canaan, and made his offspring many. Now therefore revere the Lord, and serve him in sincerity and faithfulness. Put away the gods that your ancestors served beyond the river, and in Egypt, and serve the Lord. Now if you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt and out of the house of slavery, and who did these great signs in our sight. He protected us all along the way we went, and among all the peoples through whom we passed. The Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore, we will also serve the Lord, for he is our God." But Joshua said to the people, "You cannot serve the Lord, for he is a holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your transgressions or your sins. If you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, then he will turn and do you harm and consume you after having done you good." And the people said to Joshua, "No, we will serve the Lord." Then Joshua said to the people, "You are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen the Lord to serve him." And they said, "We are witnesses." He said, "Then put away the foreign gods that are among you, and incline your hearts to the Lord, the God of Israel." The people said to Joshua, "The Lord our God we will serve, and him we will obey." So Joshua made a covenant with the people that day, and made statutes and ordinances for them at Shechem. The word of the Lord.
Listen well, O peoples of the earth, to inner promptings of the Spirit. Let silence enter your house that you may hear. For within your heart love speaks, not with words of deceit, but of spiritual truths to guide you upon the paths of peace. Do not hide this from your children. Teach of the inward voice and help all generations to listen in the silence, that they may know the beloved and be free to follow the precepts of love. For the spirit of truth is written upon open hearts, that we might share the divine plan and model to the children love's way as we have been shown, that each new generation might honor silence the children yet unborn. Herein lies the hope of the future, to live as co-creators with the great Creator, not like those who live in ignorance, too impatient to wait for love's word, whose spirits are not faithful to their birthright of love.
We do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Brown skin God, look upon the world you have entered with compassion, even to those who hung you up on that tree, for healing the sick and being with the despised, for seeing us as your image, mirror of the divine, all daughters and sons, helping them to paint a canvas with their pain, rendering their cries into poetry, words heard without need for refrain, as you sink down into the cursed cross, suffocating, you breathe your last. Brown-skinned God, do not abandon us. Both those who hung you there and those who took you down, to clean your battered and bloody body, treating it as if it were the same flesh and blood, the same fragile skin, that thing that separates you from me, that thing we all share.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight, there was a shout, 'Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him.' Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise replied, "No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves." And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later the other bridesmaids came also, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he replied, "Truly I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
You know, I've seen the text that we read this morning used to frighten, intimidate, and manipulate people into certain beliefs. At times, they've been used almost as a form of religious abuse. We have in the Old Testament a jealous and angry God. Then we have foolish virgins in the New Testament who are refused entry into a wedding banquet. And we have Jesus coming back suddenly and without warning. And yet Paul says somehow we're supposed to comfort and encourage one another with these words. Well, let's start with the story of the 10 bridesmaids. Matthew is the only gospel that records this story, and there is no detailed explanation like the kind Jesus usually provides. Just an ominous sounding moral at the end of the parable where he says, "Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." Well, the plot of our story is simple. We have 10 bridesmaids waiting to escort the groom to the wedding party, as was the custom. Now, some of them took their charge seriously by preparing and taking extra oil for their lamps in case they ran out. Others, however, brought only the oil that was already in their lamp. So basically, they just showed up. Now, the groom was held up, probably by the photographer, it doesn't say, but I'm guessing, and all of the bridesmaids fell asleep. So when the groom finally does arrive, many of them had run out of oil and had to go down to the store and pick up some more. Meanwhile, though, the groom and the bridesmaids who had prepared ahead of time by bringing the extra oil, also known as the wise bridesmaids, they all head down to the reception and have a fabulous party. And those who came late because they needed more oil were rather rudely turned away from the party by the groom himself. In no uncertain terms, he says, "Truly, I tell you, I do not know you." Growing up, this was a frightening parable for me. It seemed like these bridesmaids made one mistake and they're out. So I spent a lot of time wondering if I was doing the right things, if I was believing the right way, if I had prepared properly. I mean, what does that even look like? Well, frankly, I kind of gave up because it seemed like I would never know what was enough. But it turns out that the harsh words of the groom are actually the good news of Jesus Christ. It's not about who was better prepared. The relationship the groom had with the wise bridesmaids didn't happen because of their preparation. Rather, their preparation was a result of the relationship they already had with the groom. I'm going to say that one more time. The relationship the groom had with the wise bridesmaids didn't happen because of their preparation. Rather, their preparation was a result of a relationship they already had with the groom. You know, they prepared because they knew him. They prepared their lamps because they knew he was able to delight, surprise, and astound. They prepared their lamps because they knew he was kind and generous, and he knew how to throw a party. They prepared their lamps because they knew their lives would be better by spending time with them. So that little bit of extra effort it took to bring some extra oil, that was well worth it. Trimming the lamps was a response to the nature and character of the groom, not simply obedience to a role. You know, Jesus says at the very beginning of this story that this is about the kingdom of heaven. Or as we like to call it around here, the kinship of heaven. And we like to use that term because of the relational nature of God in our lives and the interconnectedness we all have with one another and the interconnectedness we have with creation as well. In fact, God is so relational that the Bible indicates that relationship precedes our very existence. Let me see if I can tie this together a little bit. So the rabbinic tradition teaches that even the creation story is about relationships. They say, why did God need to say out loud, let there be light, let there be plants, and let there be all this stuff? Why didn't he just do it? The rabbis teach that the creation story is a beautiful call and response narrative where God created the potential for all living things. And then he says, let there be light. And the universe responds by fully expressing the potential that God placed within it. And when it happens, God says, ooh, that's good. So the relationship not only precedes our existence, it defines it as well. And if we choose to do so, we can connect to this conversation God has been having with creation since its very inception. You know, God does the same thing within us by creating the potential to which we respond. And Jesus showed us both how to do this as human beings, and then he made it possible as well. He not only helps us hear God in our hearts, he helps us answer through the way we live our lives. And this is what Joshua was asking the people in the Old Testament passage we read today, when he was asking Israel, you know, are you sure you want to serve this God? This is not like the gods you're used to, the ones where you have all the say and all of the control. This is not a God you pray to and make your sacrifices to and go about your little religious dance. No, this is a living presence who is interactive and relational. This is a holy God, a divine experience who wants to be a part of our everyday life. In fact, this God jealously desires a place in our hearts where we can commune intimately and freely. This God expects us to listen and respond, because that's what you do in a relationship. So Joshua says, are you sure? Are you sure you want this? And the foolish bridesmaids say, you know, we prefer to go through the motions and play our role, but the kind of relationship you're describing sounds like it could get uncomfortable. You know, we might actually be asked to do something when things are out of whack with God's way of love. We might actually be asked to stand up for our fellow human beings when they are mistreated. We might actually be asked to fight for the well-being of the earth. And we might be asked to give up something that we just don't feel like giving up. We don't want to be bothered. Thank you very much. But the wise bridesmaids, they are in tune with this song of love, and they can't wait to respond by living their best lives and by lighting the way for others to do the same. So we might say that the kinship of heaven is like a group of women who knew what it meant to love. So they made the necessary sacrifices to usher it into the world. And then they celebrated with a fabulous party. Therefore, comfort and encourage one another with these words.
An affirmation of faith from the United Church of Canada. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus, crucified and risen, our judge and our hope. In life, in death, in life beyond death, God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen.
The Prayers of the People from Women's Uncommon Prayer. Open our lips, O Spirit, that we may proclaim your benevolent truth and call for justice in our communities, in our congregations, and in the world. Spirit, open our lips. Open our minds, O Creator, that we might dream a church reconciled, a church that knows your love so abundantly it bursts with a passion for ministry, a desire to give completely, and seeks only to give back. Creator, open our minds. Open our hearts, O Giver of gifts, to be transformed by compassion, so we will serve others with humility, integrity, and urgency as your servants. Giver of gifts, open our hearts. Open our eyes, O Sanctifier of life, to the hurts and needs of others. Teach us to see where our abilities and resources can be used for good. Sanctifier of life, open our eyes. Open our hands, O Spirit, to be your instruments of witness. Help us work without caution, serve without recognition, and proclaim justice, love, and kindness in your name. Spirit, open our hands. Open our memories, O Redeemer of all, as we tenderly remember those who have asked for our prayers, including those on our prayer list, and those we now name aloud and in our hearts. Redeemer of all, open our memories. God, your love is free, your compassion unconditional, and your mercy infinite. You shower upon us gifts abundant. Grant that we may know and trust these gifts, cultivating faith-filled generosity in our lives each and every day. Amen.
Let us confess our sins to God. Creator God, long-suffering, full of grace and truth, you create us from nothing and give us life abundant. You give us new life in the water of baptism. You never turn your face from us, nor cast us aside. We confess we have turned against you and against our neighbor in thought, word, and deed. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. Restore us for the sake of your Son, and bring us to heavenly joy. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of love bring you back to all that is good in you. May you be forgiven of all wrongdoing and welcome God's grace anew in your life this day. May God's assurance strengthen your resolve to begin again in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Please greet those you are worshiping with today with love and peace. And if you are worshiping by yourself, peace all over you. Good morning and welcome home. Thank you to all who have participated in making today's service possible. A special thank you to Trinity member Amy Saylor, who preached the beautiful word that we just heard. It is wonderful to have voices in the community lifting up the message of God's love. I want to remind you that we have virtual coffee hour every Sunday immediately following this service. And you can find the link to get into that Zoom room either on this Facebook page or through our website. Today is a special coffee hour. We're going to honor and say goodbye to our wonderful music director, Nate Leonard, and his husband, Spencer Wilhelm. For the past 2.5 years, they have been with us offering music and, as I've said, helped change the musical landscape of Trinity's community. Please stop by for just a little bit, at least to say thank you and goodbye to them as they make their way in the world to find other ways of being God's love. I also want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. The results of our pledge drive are now in, and while we are always eager to receive more pledges and more commitments of faith, we have exceeded our goal of the number of pledges that we were looking for this year and our dollar amount. Your faith-filled generosity is a sign of abundance and hope in this otherwise challenging season. Thank you so much for the commitment that you make to supporting and being engaged in this ministry in the year to come. This coming Saturday, the monthly men's Bible study will be gathering virtually again to open scripture and to have some time for fellowship for the men in this parish. Please go to our Zoom room link and on the website and tune in. Whether you have been to this group before or not, all are welcome and wanted. For the past few months, we have opened our doors ever so slightly to let some vital ministries continue on in safe ways at Trinity. One of those ministries is our noonday AA meeting. It is a support for those who are struggling and surviving with addictions, and we have done so faithfully with the coordinator, Ray Levy, who so faithfully shows up every day to prepare for that gathering. And you can see that the chairs are spaced apart. Not everyone can be in attendance. The number has dropped to keep it safe, but we are so grateful for his faithfulness and for being a bright spot in that part of people's lives every day of the week. It's now the time that we move into the offertory, a time of thanksgiving, a time of expressing our faith-filled generosity by supporting this ministry. To do that, please go to our website, click on the Giving tab, drop that down, choose today's date, and then give and give generously as a thanksgiving for all that God gives to us. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Most days I wake up with a pit in my chest. There are thoughts that I can't put to rest. There's a worry that I can't place. Most nights I am restless and quiet won't come. So I lay there and wait for the sun. There's a trouble that won't show its face. You came out of nowhere and you cut through all the noise. I make sense of the madness when I listen to your voice. Darling, only you can ease my mind. Help me leave these lonely thoughts behind. When they pull me under and I can feel my sanity start to unwind. Darling, only you can ease my mind. I'll admit, for a moment I felt so afraid, just to show you the mess that I made. There are pieces I usually hide, but when you collect me with your steady hand, with a language that I understand, I feel put back together inside. You came out of nowhere, and you cut through all the noise. Oh, I make sense of the madness when I listen to your voice. Oh, darling, only you can ease my mind. Feel my sanity start to unwind. Oh, darling, only you can ease my mind. Darling, only you can ease my mind. Help me leave these lonely thoughts behind. When they pull me under, and I can feel my sanity start to unwind. Darling, only you can ease my mind.
The Lord's Prayer from the New Zealand Prayer Book. Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and that shall be, Father and Mother of us all. Loving God, in whom is heaven, the hallowing of your name echo through the universe. The way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. Your heavenly will be done by all created beings. Your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and come on earth. In times of temptation and test, strengthen us. From the trials too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Amen.
My friends, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who travel with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. And may the rain fall off your shoulders when you're caught in a storm. When the frost comes a-calling, may it find you safe and warm. May your place be set, and may your promises be kept, and may you never forget that you are loved. And the blessing of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, descend upon you and saturate your beautiful hearts this day and forevermore. Amen.
I have heard my people cry.
peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here I am.